And now,
The Space presents WWE WrestleMania Kickoff.
Excitement is in the air as we get ready for our 2K WrestleMania live stream coming up at 7 Eastern. We are live from the Death Star Las Vegas, and this is what we have prepared for you tonight. We're going to kick things off exactly at 7 Eastern with a battle between Goldberg and Samoa Joe. You can't miss that. Also tonight, the winner of the Royal Rumble, Becky Lynch, will go one-on-one against the SmackDown Women's Champion, Shayna Baszler. The legit boss, Sasha Banks, goes one-on-one against WWE Hall of Famer Trish Stratus, making her return to the ring tonight at WrestleMania. Tonight here on the Kickoff Show, you'll see the Women's Tag Team Championships on the line. Ember Moon and Bianca Belair will defend against the Iconics. Raw Women's title will be up for grabs since the champion Bayley defending against the newcomer Rhea Ripley tonight, live at WrestleMania. The game Triple H, the Phenomenal One, AJ Styles in a match that will now be contested under No Holds Barred tonight at WrestleMania. Winner of the Royal Rumble, Kevin Owens, challenges WWE Champion Seth Rollins for the championship in one of our main events tonight. The Rated R Superstar Edge looks to settle the score with the man who tried to end his career, Randy Orton, tonight at WrestleMania. DIY will take on the Usos for the Tag Team Championships in a match that you will see in the main event of our kickoff show tonight. The big dog Roman Reigns goes one-on-one against Drew McIntyre. The new Roman Reigns alongside Paul Heyman looks to win the World Heavyweight Championship. Also tonight, Cruiserweight Championship ladder match. Mandrews defends against five other Cruiserweights. Who will walk out champion? We'll find out tonight. Here on the kickoff show, you'll see The Fiend Bray Wyatt challenging Braun Strowman inside the Firefly Funhouse. Whatever that means. Daniel Bryan will take the challenge from the Bruiserweight Pete Dunne, and you'll see that tonight in the main card at WrestleMania. Finn Balor will put his Money in the Bank briefcase on the line against former Mr. Money in the Bank himself, Adam Cole, who will walk out with the briefcase. We'll find out tonight. The Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal return, but here on the kickoff show, you'll see the WrestleMania Women's Battle Royal tonight. Also tonight, Bobby Lashley challenges Cesaro for the United States Championship on the main card. And coming up next to kick things off, we'll have the Intercontinental Championship up for grabs. Sami Zayn defends against The Miz and Shinsuke Nakamura, and that match starts right now. The Awesome One, 9-time Intercontinental Champion, The Miz.
The following contest is a triple threat match and is for the WWE Intercontinental Championship. Introducing the challenger and residing in Hollywood, California. Weighing in at 221 pounds, The Miz!
The Miz, looking to make history tonight. If he were to become a 10-time Intercontinental Champion, all he has to do is win this match. Or standing in his way is this man, former Intercontinental Champion, the artist known as Shinsuke Nakamura. Nakamura could say that Miz has a lot of responsibility in him not being champion at the moment.
And introducing the challenger from Kyoto, Japan. Weighing in at 220 pounds, he is the artist known as Shinsuke Nakamura!
He was back at Fastlane when The Miz stopped stuck his nose where he didn't belong and interfered in the Intercontinental Championship match between Shinsuke Nakamura and Sami Zayn. Of course, we come to find out that it was at the behest of Sami Zayn, Zayn asking The Miz for an assistance in the match in order to win the Intercontinental Championship so that The Miz could later have an opportunity at the title. SmackDown management found out about the whole hoorah and we ended up with this triple threat match. Of course, Nakamura owed a rematch after losing the championship. Miz owed a match from the deal he made with Sami Zayn, and now this man has a lot of trouble in his hands.
And introducing the champion from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 212 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, Sami Zayn!
Intercontinental Champion Sami Zayn thought he was really smart enlisting The Miz to help him win the Intercontinental Championship. He thought that by offering Miz a future opportunity at the championship, he'd be done. What he did not expect was the decision by the SmackDown management to put him in this triple threat match where the odds of Sami Zayn retaining are actually shrunken. Intercontinental Championship on the line. This is our first title match of the evening. There's the bell. Here we go. I see title up for grabs, and everybody turns their attention to Miz, and Miz, dare I say, wisely rolls out of the ring, letting Sami Zayn and Nakamura fight amongst themselves. That's exactly what we're seeing here. Sami Zayn and Shinsuke Nakamura going after each other, and Miz just watching from ringside. To the arm of Shinsuke Nakamura. And now Sami Zayn heads to the top. Bro! Oh no! Nakamura got both of his knees up and Sami Zayn crashed and burned. This is an opportunity for Shinsuke Nakamura to take the advantage. And again, The Miz just watching this match from ringside. Is it smart for Sami Zayn and Shinsuke Nakamura to allow The Miz to just watch this match walking around ringside? I think perhaps is this what Sami Zayn wanted? Perhaps The Miz promising not to be completely involved in this match and then Miz could get a one-on-one match at the title later. Hung off the ropes there. Oh, nice reversal there by Zayn. Beautiful kick. And Zayn now looking to capitalize off the reversal he provided. Reversal there by Shinsuke Nakamura moving out of the way, but Nakamura now sent into the ropes, tilt to roll backbreaker by the champion. Insane, he's not done again. Miz just chilling down here at ringside in front of our announce table. One could think this could perhaps be another deal with Sami Zayn, and maybe these two just continue to be in cahoots. But is it beneficial for Miz to just stand back and watch in this match rather than participate in it? Miz could gain a singles match at the championship later on, but if the moment is right, he should get involved in this match, and we're seeing it here. Nakamura trying to make Sami Zayn tap out of the armbar, and Miz gets involved. And now Miz using the ropes for help with that powerbomb. And I think the partnership between Nakamura, the partnership between Sami Zayn and Miz may dissolve here as Miz fires back at Sami Zayn. Now Zayn rolls out of the ring, and this comes down to Miz and Nakamura. Now the over the top rope, Miz crashes and burns. This match continues when our kickoff show returns live. And we're back live on the WrestleMania kickoff show. Miz breaking up another cover here. Miz finally being involved in this match for the Intercontinental Championship. And Nakamura was going for Kinshasa there. Miz with a wonderful reversal using a drop toe hold. Went right up to the legs of Shinsuke Nakamura and neutralizing the number one contender. And while Miz turns to the champion here, big boot down goes Sammy. Miz in the corner. What is Sami Zayn thinking here? Zayn has got Miz in a bad position here. And oh my goodness, look at Sami Zayn with an DDT! And I agree with the WWE Universe. This is awesome! Pulling out all the stops here tonight in this Intercontinental Championship match. The first match of WrestleMania. Nakamura though now taking it to Sami Zayn, and Miz just needing a second to recuperate after that DDT from Sami Zayn. It's been a while since we've seen Sami Zayn pull up something like that. Zayn now tossing Nakamura back in the ring. A block here by Shinsuke Nakamura. Sami Zayn and Nakamura trading shots. Zayn hooking Nakamura into the suplex. You know, for all of his complaints about there being a conspiracy against them and all of that, Sami Zayn, already a three-time Intercontinental Champion, Sami Zayn sure knows how to get wins, even if there was a conspiracy against him. The reversal here by Sami Zayn. Meanwhile, here's Miz! Has been very appropriate in picking his spots. But wait a second, Sami Zayn puts him into his cover here, and Nakamura breaks it off. It's funny enough, I'm praising Miz about picking the correct spot, and then he almost loses the match and immediately heads back to the outside again. He wants none of that. Nakamura going for that armbar again, but of course there's Miz. With the big boot to Shinsuke Nakamura, turning his attention to Sami Zayn. Zayn with the reversal going right after the leg of Miz. Miz with the reversal going right after the leg of Sami. Shoulders down here, Miz looking to win his 10th Intercontinental Championship, and a kick out by Sami Zayn. Now Zayn sent shoulder first into the turnbuckle post. The knee crashing across the face and torso of Sami Zayn, leading into a cover by Miz. Hooks the leg for the Intercontinental Championship. And kick out by Sami Zayn. Meanwhile, Nakamura's back in this match. Dishing out kicks. Sami Zayn putting a stop to The artist known as Shinsuke Nakamura, and as soon as Sami Zayn turns his attention to Nakamura, that is the sign for Miz to just get out of the ring. And now Nakamura may be going for the Kinshasa! Kinshasa by Nakamura, but Miz is back in the match! Nakamura reverses Miz. Miz fires back at Nakamura. Kick to the plexus by Miz. And this could be a vintage Miz move. DDT connects! And now Miz! Picking his spot, Nakamura is down. He turns his attention to Sami Zayn for the skull! Crushing finale! Hooks the inside leg! Miz is a 10-time champion!
Here is your winner, and the new WWE Intercontinental Champion, The Miz!
And we're already starting the night off in style, ladies and gentlemen. We already have a title change. The Miz is your new Intercontinental Champion, and there is still a lot left, not only here on the WrestleMania kickoff show, but on our WrestleMania livestream coming up later. Later here on the kickoff show, you'll see the Tag Team Championships defended. It'll be DIY challenging the Usos for those Tag Team titles. That's later tonight, and here on the kickoff show is the only place where you'll see The Fiend, Bray Wyatt, and Braun Strowman in the Firefly Funhouse. But coming up next, the WrestleMania Women's Battle Royal. Let's send it out to ringside. And here we go. It's the WrestleMania Women's Battle Royal. Finally underway. We've got in the ring Candice LeRae, Asuka, Alexa Bliss. And there goes Lacey Evans, the first elimination at the hands of Nia Jax and Carmella. Ruby Riott and Sonya Deville, and of course the now eliminated Lacey Evans. The Women's Battle Royal Trophy on the line. Ruby Riott in trouble trying to skin the cat, but Alexa Bliss eliminates her, and that's our second elimination in the Women's Battle Royal. Already out, Lacey Evans and Ruby Riott. Alexa taking it to Sonya Deville, and now Nia Jax is trying to sneak up on Alexa Bliss. Instead, turns her focus to Asuka. Nia Jax has had a quite impressive couple of months. There with Asuka. Asuka giving it her all. Meanwhile, LeRae with Alexa Bliss. Thinking suplex perhaps, but a great reversal there by Alexa. Now Alexa sends her bouncing on the corner. Meanwhile, Mella and Deville locking up. Oh, now there's an elimination! Candice LeRae eliminated at the hands of Alexa Bliss. And another elimination! Carmella takes out Sonya Deville. And we're down to four. Alexa Bliss, Asuka. Nia Jackson, Carmella, as Alexa works to try and eliminate Asuka. And on the other side of the ring, Nia Jax trying to eliminate Carmella. Alexa Bliss taking it to Asuka. These two old rivals here. Meanwhile, Nia Jax still working to try and eliminate Carmella. Big shots there by Nia Jax. Carmella just looking to fight back, but Nia Jax with an answer. Jax with the powerbomb. We are just minutes away from WrestleMania kicking off. The main card starts in just a few minutes at the top of the hour, right here on the space. Vintage bleeds to the double knees. And Jax is in trouble, and Asuka is in trouble at the hands of Bliss. Asuka's out. And then there were three. Carmella, Nia Jax, and Alexa Bliss. Nia Jax working her hardest to eliminate Carmella here. Carmella in a very precarious position, could be out of the WrestleMania Women's Battle Royal. Carmella with the reversal. Jax turns her attention to Bliss, which must feel like a curse if you're Alexa. Powerbomb by Nia Jax, but Carmella should not have taken her eye off the ball. It's all Nia Jax at this moment, and it seems like this entire thing is made perfect for Nia Jax. And Jax set over the turn rope. Skin in the cap for Carmella. Or I should say Alexa Bliss. Skin in the cap, but Alexa Bliss eliminates her. And now we're down to two. Mella tries to go for the super kick on Alexa Bliss. The reversal by Bliss. And now, Little Miss Bliss picking up Carmella. Tossing her out of the ring. This match is over. Alexa Bliss wins the Battle Royal.
Here is your winner, Alexa Bliss.
It's Alexa Bliss picking up the victory at the WrestleMania Women's Battle Royal. Here tonight, are we seeing a renaissance of Little Miss Bliss? And we are back live at WrestleMania. Women's Tag Titles on the line. Next. The EST of WWE. Bianca Belair making her way out here. And what led to her partnership with Ember Moon has been very interesting. As we see it on your screens, Women's Tag Team Championships up for grabs. And the ref about to make this one official. Just a couple of months ago, Ember Moon and Bianca Belair both targeted by the current Women's Tag Team Champions at the time, Mickie James and Lacey Evans. There's a... this match gets underway, shoulders down! And a kick out. Pushing Billy Kay. And Billy Kay fires back at Bianca Belair. Look at that. Forearm shot by Billy Kay. Shoulders down here. And a kick out. Iconics for the first ever Women's Tag Team Champions. Winning those championships back in the summer of 2019. And they are looking to become the first ever two-time Women's Tag Team Champions. Great reversal here by Bianca Belair. And Billy Kay quickly not letting off of Bianca Belair. Versus the arm drag. Quickly suffering the ref of the Iconics. She has managed though to avoid any tags Until now, Peyton Royce getting into this match. Off the tag into a suplex. Shoulder stomping, almost had enough to throw away the kick out. Sending Royce into the corner, Royce fires back. And now Royce. Another arm drag this time, that leads into a tag. Here comes Ember Moon. And Ember Moon doesn't quite hit with that drop kick. We got a bit of a standoff here. Ember Moon looking to fire back, and she sends Peyton Royce into the canvas. Well, for a super kick there, doesn't quite work. That leads into a cover. Too close to the ropes, the match continues. Into the corner, nobody there for Peyton Royce to hit that spinning kick. But a great reversal there by Peyton. Knee to the head. And now Peyton hits the DDT. Sent into the corner there now. Shoulder first into the turnbuckle post. Shot with a knee, and just like that, the Iconics are rolling in this match. Trouble here for Ember Moon as she gets driven into the bottom rope. We all know under that white tape there's a wire, metal wires that are certainly going to cause a lot of damage to you if you run into them. Moon sending into the ropes for her arm drag. Oh, and looking at the wrong side of the ring if she was looking for a tag. Oh! What a kick by Peyton. Shoulders down, hooks the leg to put her away and a kick out. Incredible. Peyton Royce managing not to lose control of this match even after the kick out. By Ember Moon, she heads to the top rope, lands down the plancha, leads into a cover, hooks a leg. Is it enough to win the tag titles and a kick out? And just like that, Ember Moon just trying to flip this match towards her favor. Great reversal here by Peyton. Who's got Ember on the ropes. And look at this. Look at the way Peyton using the ropes to her advantage. Ember perhaps is thinking of going for a tag there. Peyton realized Ember had to roll out of the ring, but she's still in a precarious position here. Ember propping back up to her feet with a keep up. Finally, Royce finds himself in the wrong zip code. Tag is made. Here comes Bianca Belair. Belair off the second rope goes after the arm of Peyton Royce. Peyton Royce in trouble being carried by Bianca Belair. Look at the power. Look at the strength. Look at Bianca Belair. Shoulders down. Hoofs the leg. Is it enough to retain the tag titles? And Royce powers out at two. Whoa, what a spear. Beautiful spear by Peyton Royce, hooks the leg to win the tag titles and a kick out. Absolutely amazing match that we're watching here tonight for the Women's Tag Team Championships as Royce not holding anything back against Bianca Belair. Locking in the submission maneuver using the rope for her favor. There's only so much to do here before the referee asks for the break. And look at that kick! That sends Bianca reeling to the outside of the ring. Oh, there's that spinning heel kick again. And if you had any doubts, how about the Iconics They're certainly putting them to rest in this huge match. At the granddaddy of them all, with the women's tag titles up for grabs, Royce lands the knee across the chest of Bianca Belair. Now Belair sent into the ropes, of Belair blocking Peyton Royce, very smart. To the ropes, corner tag, here comes Billy Kay. Kay going after the arm, very wisely. Now over the third rope, Bianca Belair and Peyton Royce gets involved, sending Belair face first into the apron. That's the hardest part of the ring, and then applying an egg breaker. Meanwhile, on the other side of the ring, Billy Kay hooks in, Ember Moon for a swinging egg breaker. Things are rolling for the Iconics here at WrestleMania. Count of four here. Billy Kay continuing to take care of Ember Moon. Bianca Belair coming back like a house on fire. Going for a kick. Shoulders down to win the tag team titles. Shoulders down on Bianca Belair. Belair in trouble. She powers out of two. Belair pushing. Oh, what a kick to the gut there by Billy Kay. And there's the body slam. And the tag is made. Here comes Peyton Royce. Royce going for that combination of suplex. Here we go once again. That leads into a cover, but it's so close. It's so close to the ropes. The tag is made. Here comes Billy Kay. Quick tags. Proving to be the winner for the Iconics. Tag is made again. Peyton back in the role. And now, we may see the lethal combination of suplexes again. Peyton Royce leads into the Northern Lights. Shoulders to the mat to win the tag titles. Yes, sir, the Iconics are two-time champions.
Are your winners and the new WWE Women's Tag Team Champions, Peyton Royce and Billy Kay.
Oh!
We welcome you back to the WrestleMania Kickoff Show, and I'm still a little shaken from what we just saw, but nonetheless, the Tag Team Championships are on the line coming up next.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and is for the WWE Tag Team Championship. Introducing the challengers. At a combined weight of 400 pounds, Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa, DIY!
DIY making their way out here for this Tag Team Championship match, our final match of the WrestleMania Kickoff Show. DIY won the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic to get here.
And introducing the champions. At a combined weight of 479 pounds, they are the Jey Uso and Jimmy Uso, the Uso.
If anybody has had the opportunity to sit back and just watch things unfold, it has been the Usos. The WWE Tag Team Champions sat on the sidelines as they watch the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic take place, all waiting for a number one contender at their titles to be crowned. That contender has been named. The match takes place right now. There you see it. The official making this match, well, official, excuse the redundancy. There's the bell. Here we go. Caught on a bow tie up between Uso and Gargano. And Jay in control of Johnny here. Johnny wrestling now, taking the waist, but Jay bringing it back to the headlock. What a story it would be for DIY to win the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic and make it all the way to WrestleMania as your tag team champions. We want to talk about somebody who has benefited from circumstance. The Usos were there the night that Edge betrayed, or I should say the night that Randy Orton betrayed Edge. You see attack, Tommaso Ciampa is here. We may be seeing some tag team wrestling there. Tandem offense by DIY. Another light suplex. And a cover by Tommaso Ciampa. Quick kick out by the Usos. Jay needs to tag out to Jimmy, perhaps. Ole! Down to the outside goes Jay. As mentioned before, the Usos won the Tag Team Championships back in December. It was no mercy in what is now known as an infamous night when Edge was a victim of a ravage. A savage attack by Randy Orton. Orton would just steal chair and punt Edge in the head, and we thought Edge might never come back from it until tonight when the Rated R Superstar takes on Randy Orton at WrestleMania, and it all kicks off. It all starts soon, ladies and gentlemen. Stick around. We're going to be here all night. Thank you for joining us through the pre-show. WrestleMania continues through the rest of the night right here on the space, and you can watch anytime on demand. And while we're on the subject, thank you so much for 3 years of the Wrestling Space. This is our third WrestleMania live stream. We could not be prouder of the work that we're doing here on the space. We could not be happier with the results, with the way the fans are receiving our content, the way that they're participating in what we do week in and week out. This is a vanity project that turned into almost a full-time position. We thank you so much for supporting the Wrestling Space. And trust me when I tell you, the best is yet to come. Meanwhile, here's Jimmy. Ooh, he's feeling it. Here comes Jimmy flying around with the greatest of ease, wiping Tommaso Ciampa down. And the ref starts to count. You say what you will about the Usos, of course they stayed in the sidelines throughout the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. They made their comeback to SmackDown just this past week. We got a cover here, hooking both legs and a kick out. But they're not gonna let the match go into a countout, I'll say that. A groggy Tommaso Ciampa. And the tag is made. Here comes Johnny Gargano. Beautiful Samoan drop there. Wiping out Gargano and taking care of Ciampa as well. It's a 2-for-1 for the Usos. And there is that signature single leg Boston Crab locked in on Tommaso Ciampa. I should say Johnny Gargano. Jesus Christ. The show is just getting started, and I'm already messing it up. Oh, if Matthew did video game Butchamania, he would have a field day with me. Shoulders down here, hooks the leg off the super kick, is it enough, and a kick out. Also, groggy on the apron. He fires back, forearm to the face of Gargano. Gets sent into the corner. Wrong zip code. Tag is made. Here comes Jay. And there's that assisted Samoan drop by the Usos. Gargano bounces off the corner. Now Gargano looking to defend himself. Great reversal here by Jay. And now Ron Simcoe there for Jay. Did he tag? I didn't see a tag, no. He did get thwarted into the corner. Shoulders down, hooks the leg. Is it enough to put him away? And a kick out. Beautiful dropkick there by Gargano. Trying to neutralize what's happening here. Gargano may be going for the Gargano escape. Locked in. A little assistance there to break it off. A little assistance altogether. Gargano gets suplexed. And Ciampa gets brought back into the ring. DDT there. Here's a cover. I don't think that was the best idea to do that at that very moment. Missed time cover there by Gargano. Shoulders down, too close to the ropes. To the ropes, here we go. Swinging neck breaker. In need of a tag. Can't get there. Gargano gets pushed off. Gargano is not done yet. Look at that kick. Right to the back of the head. And now Ciampa. Is Ciampa in any shape to tag into this match? I don't think so. That's why Gargano is opting for another option. Right after the arm. Gargano runs tip coach. Ciampa gets involved. Shouldn't have done that, I'll tell you that. Gargano is in a world of trouble here. The Usos may have this. Off the top! Make it drop! That's some title retention right there. The Usos are still your tag team champions. Still the WWE Tag Team Champions, the Usos, get to carry the gold around and make a WrestleMania moment in the process. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the time is now. Are you ready for our biggest live stream of the year? It starts in just a couple of minutes. You don't want to miss it. WrestleMania is next. And we're going to take a look at the card one more time. At WrestleMania, we'll kick things off with Goldberg and Samoa Joe. It's gonna happen in just minutes. Also tonight, SmackDown Women's Championship up for grabs. It's Becky Lynch versus Shayna Baszler. You don't want to miss the renewal of this rivalry. The Legit Boss, Sasha Banks, takes on WWE Hall of Famer Trish Stratus in what could be Trish's final match. You don't want to miss that either. Tonight at WrestleMania, Raw Women's Champion Bayley defends that championship against Rhea Ripley. And tonight, Triple H goes one-on-one against the phenomenal one, AJ Styles. You don't want to miss that one. No holds barred. And speaking of no holds barred, ladder match for the Cruiserweight Championship, Mandrews will put that title in a melee of five other Cruiserweights. Also tonight at WrestleMania, Daniel Bryan will go one-on-one against Pete Dunne. This one ought to be good. You don't want to miss it. Bryan Dunne tonight. Finn Balor's Money in the Bank briefcase will be on the line as he goes one-on-one against Adam Cole. Will we get a new Mr. Money in the Bank? WWE Champion Seth Rollins defense against the winner of the Royal Rumble, Kevin Owens. Will KO Mania 5 be the one where KO finally finds success? The Rated R Superstar Edge tries to get revenge against his now nemesis Randy Orton, and you'll see it tonight. The big dog Roman Reigns has changed his attitude and he's going after McIntyre's world title tonight at WrestleMania. Ladies and gentlemen, the time is now. The moment is here. WrestleMania is coming up next.